Some acids can donate multiple protons. When dealing with such systems, simply treat each proton transfer one at a time. In other words, do the same calculation we just outlined for the first proton, without worrying that more protons are to follow. Once completed, proceed to the next proton transfer. Repeat as necessary until all of the possible protons are donated. The only complication, other than the repeated steps, is to keep in mind that the preceding proton transfer will generate the initial values for the proton transfer with which we are currently dealing. The prime example would be the initial hydronium concentration. It would not be zero. It would be equal to the hydronium concentration found within the calculation for the preceding proton transfer. Also, the current acid would be the conjugate base of the preceding calculation, and its initial concentration would be found from said preceding calculation. The dissociation constants of a weak acid and its conjugate base share a special relationship. We see that their product gives the equilibrium constant for the autoionization of water. So, at 25 degrees Celsius, the product of Ka and Kb will yield 1.0 times 10 to the negative 14. This is useful as we often need the dissociation constant of the weak acid or base, but the only experimental data available is that of its conjugate. Fortunately, we see that it is a rather simple transformation to get the required dissociation constant. Finally, this relationship shows that as the weak acid gets stronger and its dissociation constant gets bigger, the dissociation constant of its conjugate base must necessarily get smaller as the product is fixed at 1.0 times 10 to the negative 14. We have talked about acids and bases. We typically think of salts, the products of an acid-base neutralization, as not affecting the pH. This is the case for the most common of salts, sodium chloride. The pH of a sodium chloride solution is that of pure water, 7.00, as the sodium cation and the chloride anion are inert spectator ions. But when we neutralize either a weak acid or a weak base, the result is a salt containing its conjugate, which has its own acid-base properties. So look at the cation and the anion in the salt. If the cation is a weak acid, the pH of the salt solution will be lower than 7. If the anion is a weak base, the pH of the salt solution will be higher than 7. And, if we are in a situation where both the cation is a weak acid and the anion is a weak base, then the stronger of the two will ultimately determine whether or not the pH will be lower or higher than 7.